All right, even more fun news now. If you like March Madness, the Tri-State is an insane asylum with all of our major teams competing for the NCAA basketball crown.
Yeah, an insane asylum in our newsroom, too. UK played this afternoon. They did beat Princeton. Boy, it was a nail-biter. And now the Bearcats tipping off tonight, and the Tri-State's best coverage starts with George Vogel live at our exclusive Washington, D.C. bureau tonight. Hi, George.
Hey, how you doing? We're outside today, and it is beautiful here in Washington, D.C. And I tell you, the NCAA tournament, you know you're going to get college basketball fans, but you just don't know where they're from. Just because a guy's wearing a UC hat doesn't mean he's from Cincinnati. Fans from everywhere show up at the NCAA tournament. The action is picking up outside the Verizon Center on this game day, assorted school colors, and plenty of green for St. Patty's Day. Everyone has their reasons to root for a team. We found one UC fan from the hometown of a Bearcat player and a DC local in a UC tie who is a transplant from Cincinnati.
Actually, the only grief I caught was that today is St. Patrick's Day, so, you know, people were expecting the green tie, but I told them that, you know, I wore the green yesterday, and today was for the Bearcats.
White Plains, Sean Kilpatrick, first NCAA tournament, first two Big East tournaments was because he was at UC, so we're here, we're supporting him.
Yeah, Chris said it's his first NCAA tournament. He comes all the way from New York, and he flew in. We caught him when he just got out of a cab from the airport, and he said this is his first tournament, and he's here because of Sean Kilpatrick. So Kilpatrick already with a fan club, and I understand it's a pretty big one from White Plains, New York. So we'll see if Sean Kilpatrick and the Bearcats live to see another day. They play against Mizzou tonight, about a 9:45 tip-off. If they win that, they will play again Saturday. Reporting live from the nation's capital, I'm George Vogel, News 5.